Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with the today's lead editorial. Now today's lead editorial is about the Communist Party of India's relationship and survivability as an ideology. Now primarily the author is talking about CPI Maoists, and he's also talking about the Naxalbari movement. So actually he has intermingled all these things: Communist Party of India, Communist Party of Maoists, and Naxalbari movement. Now all these ideologies, they are actually different. So we need to go in the nitty-gritties of CPI and CPI Maoists and Naxalbari movement. And before we do that, we basically need to understand different forms of socialism. Now the first core form of socialism that we have, it is Marxism. Now what is the meaning of Marxism? Now according to Marx, the core ideology of Communist Party of India, the Marxism says that in order to bring about a revolution, it is the entire society which should get together, and they should actually try to dislodge the capitalism, the bourgeoisie class. It should be the proletariat class from which the revolution should be coming, and they should collectively be hitting against the bourgeoisie class. So this was the belief system of the Marxism. And this belief system of Marxism didn't believe in the system of party. Now according to Marxism, first of all the socialism would be established, and from socialism the communism would be established. So these will be the stages of how the communism will be actually established. But when these things were put into practice in Russia, we had a different form of communism. And that form of communism is known as Leninism. Now this is very important. Leninism, it believes in the political party. It believes that there should be a political party of the workers who should be protecting for the interests of the workers, and they should try to create an egalitarian society. So Marxism didn't believe in any political party. Leninism believed in a political party. Now the third form of communism that we have is Maoism. Now Maoism was practiced as the form of communism that believed that the egalitarian society would be created if we will practice the principle of Maoism. And according to Maoism, the power should come from the barrel of the gun. It should flow from the barrel of the gun. According to Maoism, there should be revolution, and this revolution should be on the basis of violence. So Maoism primarily believes in violence. Now Leninism, it believes in party. Marxism believes in the revolution by the masses, the proletariat class, whereas Maoism believes in violence. It believes that the revolution can be brought only by means of violence. Now the third type of that we have, the fourth type that we have is Naxal movement. Now, generally what the authors do, they try to categorize this Maoism and Naxalism in one category, but this is not the truth. Now when it comes to Naxalism, it doesn't believe completely in violence tactics. Naxalism also believes in electoral systems. And Naxal movement has actually been overlapped with this Maoism movement. So we are not able to differentiate between Maoism and Naxalism the way it is practiced at the ground level in India. Now Naxalism, it has got more to do with the revolution which can be brought in by the peasant class. It started from that. But it has a belief system, some kind of a belief system in democracy development too. No, but when it comes to Marxism, Leninism and Maoism, they actually don't believe in the system of democracy. The Naxalism is also not entirely favoring democracy, but it has a kind of inclination towards that thing. Now, the author today has talked in the editorial, he has talked about that how the Communist Party of India, Maoist, is bereft, or it is getting bereft of ideology. Now, bereft of ideology means that it is not fighting for any cause, kind of cause. It has just become more or less like a terrorist movement. It is not a movement of communism. It is just a terrorist movement, the way it is functioning in India. But to decide about whether this is right or whether it is wrong, it is upon the viewers of this editorial class. Because I am no one to comment on this. Whether it is ideology less or it is full of ideology. Or still, in the Communist Party of Maoists, still we have the ideology underpinning it. Now, we also need to understand the difference between Communist Party of India and Communist Party of India Marxist. And we also need to understand what is Communist Party of India Maoists. Now, all these three political outfits and political parties, they actually are different. Now, Communist Party of Maoist, it is actually banned. Now, coming to Communist Party of India, Communist Party of India, Communist Party of India Marxist, they were nothing but the resultant of the antagonism between USSR and China in 1960s. Now, in 1960s, China began to practice a different form of communism under the influence of Marxism. Now, because in 1960s, Russia had seen as has actually undergone a change whereby it had begun to believe that the communism and the capitalism, they could be run together. So, in 1960, Russia ne communism or capitalism ko basically close karne ka koshish kiya. So, Russia ka jo communism tha 1960s ka, it was actually moderate and it was actually liberal. Whereas China's communism of that A era under Mao Zedong is concerned, it was very, very strict and it was very, very rigid. It believed in the revolution by the peasant class. So the Communist Party of India, Marxist that we have, it was created in 1964 after the split from the Communist Party of India. Now this split that took place in India was actually the resultant of the Communist Party split in USSR and China. Now China's communism was more rigid at that point of time. The Russian Revolution, the Russian Communist Party was relatively liberal in comparison to China. So it was more rigid. So the Maoism that we have in India and the Marxism that we have in India, they actually believe in revolution by way of violent means. But Maoism is an ultra and extremist form of that. So it is the difference between the Communist Party of India, Communist Party of India Marxist and Communist Party of India Maoist. And we also have the difference between different type of communism. We have the Marxism that believes in the revolution by the masses. We have Leninism that believes in the political party. We have Maoism that believes in the revolution. In order to establish communism, we need to actually indulge in violence. And Naxalbari is a pseudo form of Maoism, though it is not the same as Maoism, because it has a kind of inclination towards the democratic setup, democratic ethos and value system too. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.